Join me as I talk to Kevin about SQL 911, a new set of notebooks that he's created for SQL Server on-prem, this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. We have an exciting episode planned for you, and today I have with me Kevin from Microsoft. Kevin, thanks so much for joining us today. You know, we've never had someone from your exact role on the show before, so I'd love if you could tell us a little bit about what you do.
Hey, Anna, thanks so much. I really appreciate you taking some time to invite me to be on your program. I am a principal consultant with Microsoft, and I've been in the SQL Server space for the last 20 years. I've been with Microsoft for just over 15, and I go on site and help them design, build, and architect new data solutions, whether that be in SQL Server, on-prem, or in the cloud, as well as Power Platform and Power BI.
Awesome, cool. You really cover a lot of things, and I'm sure you've learned a lot from these deep customer engagements that you've had. Now, we want to bring you on the show today because you've actually created something really cool that I think other people are going to get a lot of use out of. Can you tell us like why you went to go create this like vast set of notebooks that we'll take a look at?
Oh, thank you. You know, you've had a lot of great guests on in the past that have talked about Azure Data Studio. And I got an idea basically on March 15th, 2020. That was a date that really changed my life. I was issued a stop movement order due to the pandemic and was no longer able to go on site and be with my customers. The staff couldn't be on site, couldn't work in their data centers, but yet their needs remained the same. The SQL servers, their data platforms still required care and feeding. And so I tried to think of a way that how can we create a remote delivery solution that would be just as good as me being on site there helping the DBAs in the data center. And so I came up with an idea to use Jupyter Notebooks as that remote solution.
Awesome. Cool. So you have this great remote solution, and I think probably using Azure Data Studio because you can store all the results, they could send them back to you, and you could, you know, help them from there. So why don't we take a look? Can you show us what it looks like and what's in there?
Oh, I'd be glad to. I'm excited to show this to you. This is the Azure Data Studio Jupyter Notebook. And think of this as a book. And there's an introduction where I basically introduce the subject and the topics and the color coding that is going to be used that will help you understand what to do, when to click, when to run a piece of code. And then what we have is a series of lessons. Each lesson builds upon the next, gaining more complexity as you progress through the notebook. And here is just a simple sample on how to connect to SQL instance, a little bit about query plans, and just kind of a general introduction. And then we have here in chapter two, how to use extension packs. Notebooks really benefit from the use of IntelliSense and things that these extension packs offer. So what I did is I had just a very small lesson. Many of you are familiar with global MVP Brent Ozar. What this is an extension pack, which uses his first responder kit. And a colleague of mine at Microsoft converted the first responder kit into an extension. And so this is just merely a step-by-step instruction on how to use this. But think of this as a mechanism for you to connect to your on-premises SQL Server and run a series of diagnostics based on type. So for example, you may want to run diagnostics against your database or perhaps indexes. And then what you'll see here is some queries that I've already pre-prepared for you that give you information. That return status of your database, perhaps when the last backup occurred. Do you have any suspect pages in your table? And then Anna, what I think is the meat and potatoes of this notebook really is in the database corruption section. This is what DBAs will face real time on site in their data centers when they come in one day, and what happens when they have a corruption error notice when they connect to their SQL Server. So what we have here, thanks to some of the great work and contributions of Paul Randall, I've got a step-by-step set of instructions on what to do when you encounter corruption on your SQL Server. Is restore the best technique? Or is perhaps doing a repair, is that a better technique for you? So this is kind of the best of breed community-baked SQL code that is safe to run on your network. And one of my favorite parts, just in closing, is what I have included in, say, for example, the maintenance section, is years worth of mathematical formulas that I've captured over the years on how to compute and calculate the size. Say, for example, as a DBA, you've been tasked to scale out your SQL Server to support database growth for 5 years. Well, how in the world are you going to do that if you don't have a formula to be able to calculate that capacity? So lots of tips and tricks in here. Another favorite one, just in closing, all of my years working on site, a question that I get so many times is, hey, if I see a page life performance counter of 600, is that a good number or a bad number? Or what if my average disk sec read is 58 milliseconds? How do I know if that's fast or slow? So your readers can download this Jupyter Notebook, clone it locally, and then all of the tips and the tricks and the magic and all of the things that I've learned over my years as a consultant working for Microsoft, I've included in this Jupyter Notebook absolutely free for your users.
Wow, this is pretty amazing, Kevin. I mean, not only have you brought everything together, but you're bringing things from the product group, from your experience in the field, from community legends like Brent and Paul, and then bringing it all so people can just connect to their server and run it and learn more. And what I love about this is you're also not just saying, hey, run this, this is what it means. Like, you're taking the time in here to actually educate folks on what's going on, what are the basics they need to know. So this is awesome. I'm really excited about this. You know, I want to go try it out, and I know we'll put the link to this in the description. But I got to ask you, like you said, this works on SQL Server on-prem. So I'm assuming it also works in the cloud, but do you have plans or ideas, or could we run it today with maybe some of our PaaS services like Managed Instance or SQL DB?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's the exciting part about this. It's been so fun developing this. And the first initial 7 chapters were, I had to start somewhere to be able to create a minimum viable product that could be used by as many people as possible.
Sure.
But the next steps over the next weeks and months, I'd really encourage your viewers to come back to that GitHub site, because I plan on adding chapters on SQL Server on Azure VM, Azure SQL Database, Azure SQL Managed Instance, those same tried and true code, queries, content, and knowledge to be able to help your users even grow their data in the cloud.
Wow, that is so awesome. Kevin, thank you so much for all the work and effort you put in with, I know, multiple people to kind of make this a reality. To our viewers, I'd encourage you to go get this from GitHub now. Check the links in the description. Kevin shared a lot of useful things that might be interesting to you as well as you kind of begin this journey of using Azure Data Studio and notebooks for analyzing what's going on and just general learning as well. So again, thanks so much, Kevin. To our viewers, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think of these notebooks in Azure Data Studio. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.